The word that's often used in fire, that's been the watchword of fire, is coordination. And we do lots of coordination, particularly on the operational level. Collaboration raises it to a new level between what we're doing, not just between and among federal agencies, but with partners at the state level, the local level, the tribal level, so on. And getting out of the operational area and talking about collaboration across the board, what we need to do to have fire-adapted communities, what we need to do to have healthy landscapes, what we need to do to have safe and effective operations, what different values and cultures have come to the table from whether we sit as a federal perspective with land to manage, or whether we sit as a community with homes to protect and families to provide for, or whether we're talking about communities that are looking at recreational opportunities, hunting and fishing and so on. So all of these are different perspectives, different values that come together in a collaborative way to say what's the best way to live with and use and protect ourselves from wildland fire. So Aaron, in the last month or two, the Wildland Fire Executive Council, the WFEC, approved the regional action plans under the cohesive strategy. Those have been collaborative efforts by the three regions for the last several months. And those plans are now being amalgamated into what will eventually be a national action plan. That's going to be supported by a national trade-off analysis, and that work is going to be continuing through this summer of 2013 to look at a number of trade-offs between the biophysical and socioeconomic environment, between various intergovernmental partners and locations and organizations, between various programs, landscapes versus protecting communities and so on. And that trade-off analysis will be a document that we can use as fire managers in all of our agencies to start looking at improving collaboration and coordination of fire management activities across the nation.